Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to teach you about the difference between gain and trim when it comes to preamps on the Behringer X32 and really any mixer that you have the ability of having gain and trim on. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, on a mixer, we need to amplify our microphone level up to line level to be able to have our mixer actually mix it to then send off to the PA. And every mixer has a nominal gain level. Now, on the Behringer X32, that happens to be between negative 18 and negative 21. On average, it's about negative 18. DBFS. And so on this mixer, this is a full scale or DBFS, which means that 0 DBFS is up at clipping and it just goes down from there. So negative 18 DBFS is the nominal gain that we'd be looking at with this mixer. Different mixers have a different level as well. And so our goal is to take this microphone and get it up to a sufficient amount of volume. And if we hit a view on our preamp section, we're wanting to try and target that negative 18 mark on our X32. Now, when we have a preamp gain, and I'm going to go select my configuration here, we're trying to get around to this negative 18 mark on our console. And that is getting enough volume on this microphone to be able to mix with the rest of the microphones on our console. So whenever we're doing a sound check, we're wanting to set the preamp gain to an appropriate level. And the best way of doing this is ask your band, instrument by instrument, to play at the loudest level that they'd be playing during show. Now, this is quite actually difficult to get to the band to actually do this. But if they can play at their loudest volume that they'd be playing during show or during their loudest chorus, that sort of thing, you can set your preamp level correctly. And at that point, you won't have to adjust the preamp level later once the band actually starts getting into their rehearsal. So you can explain that to them if you want to do it that way. It's helpful for you and for them because then their monitor levels won't change, because every time we adjust our gain level, it adjusts their monitor levels as well. So whenever we have this microphone here, we can adjust our gain up and down until we get to the point where the average amount of their signal is sitting right about negative 18, which is right here. Now I can get louder into this microphone, check 1, 2, and I'm not clipping that much. But if I have this channel and it's all the way up in the clipping range all the time, then that's definitely going to be a bad spot. Now, if you're clipping a channel, you're not going to break your console, you're not going to break anything, but you could potentially damage speakers. By having a clipped channel, you are making a square wave out of your sine wave. And so when you have a square wave that's going through speakers at a loud volume, then that's actually taking that speaker and pushing it out and having it sit there for a second and then come back and sit there for a second. And it's that sitting there that can damage speakers because it heats up the speaker coil, melts it, and that's when you blow speakers. You can catch them on fire. It's a bunch of fun stuff like that. And so preamp is actually adjusting the level on the preamp where this microphone is connected to. Now, this is going into an SD8, and I have that on a stage box that's sitting down below. And this is a preamp gain. So if I have this microphone and I'm clipping here, I can adjust my preamp gain down to a sufficient level and get this set correctly. Now, if you are in a situation where you maybe have multiple consoles on the same network attached to the same stage box, and we have this gain set at positive 60, and then we go over to our setup and preamps, and we go HA gain split. Now, this is one benefit to having multiple consoles. You can set this HA gain split, and then once you've set the preamp levels correctly, now the consoles can go and do a digital trim off of that preamp level that you already have set. And so this is when I can then go and take my channel, and I can go and adjust my trim up and down to have this set correctly in my mix. So if I'm mixing broadcast and I need a little bit more volume out of this, I can go ahead and add digital trim up. Now, when you add digital trim, you are just taking the volume of your preamp and turning it up. So if we had set a volume on this microphone preamp that was very low, and then we go add digital trim, we're not actually getting a sufficient volume on that preamp. And so if I go over to my settings and go here and turn this down, this my knob is a little sticky here, so it takes a while. Okay, so here we can see that I am negative gain on this. Now, if I go to my channel and I go boost this up, I can only get 18 dB of boost on this microphone because I'm not actually adjusting the preamp. I'm adjusting a digital version of that preamp and adding 18 dB of gain. Now, then the other option is if we have this set and we have this preamp and it's all the way up to 60, and we then are taking this microphone and we are clipping it. So check, check, check. We can see that my clip light here is activating. And if I go and adjust this trim down to negative 18, having this sit in a much better spot here, I can actually still clip this channel, and we can see this clip light is going. I can clip this channel, but my volume is in a good spot. And so this is the bad thing about digital trim, is if you set your preamp gain too low or you set your preamp gain too high, you can't affect it with digital trim. So I can't take this microphone out of clipping with digital trim. I'd have to go adjust the preamp gain at that physical spot down. Now, if you are sharing gain, what you can do is you can go to setup, go over to preamps, go find where this unit is, for instance, my AES-50B, and I can go now and adjust my preamp gain down. Now, this happens to be an issue if you are coming out of the B port of a X32 and you are, say, monitors or your front of house and your primary console is clipping the gains and sending it to you over the AES-50, your trim won't be able to take that microphone out of clipping. They would have to adjust it on that mixer down to not be clipping. So this is the main thing between digital trim and gain. Gain is your first step for getting that channel to an appropriate level to be able to mix it. And then digital trim allows you to adjust it to your taste. But digital trim is not the first step. You can't adjust gain off of digital trim. So there's a big difference between the two. Just remember that digital trim is just kind of finessing to the level that you want your faders to sit at, whereas gain is where we need to be adjusting the preamp from the very get-go. I hope this video is helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the X32 or really any of the production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you guys have a great day.